Hey everyone, my name is Josh and welcome back to your fourth stimulus package and news update. We have a lot of news to get into in today's video, but first, if you would like to receive two free stocks from Webull valued up to $2,300, make sure to claim them by clicking my link, which you will find in the description box below. Okay, so earlier this week, 90 House Democrats sent a letter to the Senate requesting that they include a path to citizenship for undocumented immigrants in the Build Back Better bill. This would be just for certain undocumented immigrants, such as essential workers and Dreamers. Although the House Democrats already included a provision that would allow for undocumented immigrants to apply for a 5-year work permit, they didn't include a route towards becoming citizens. The letter continues. They write, "Under the Constitution, Congress alone holds the power to determine who can become a citizen and under what conditions. So when Congress promises, quote, immigration reform, as it has done throughout the negotiation process, our party must fully deliver on that promise. For decades, immigrants have sought relief from the precarity of jumping from one temporary status to another in the only country they can call home. Another temporary status would merely extend this precarity. Whether we keep our promise or not is a question of political will. We do understand that the Senate parliamentarian has issued a memorandum dismissing, despite evidence to the contrary, the budgetary impact of providing a pathway to citizenship, but the role of the parliamentarian is an advisory one and the parliamentarian's opinion is not binding. As we laid out in our letter to you on October 21st, 2021, both federal law and Senate president provide that the Senate's presiding officer can issue a different binding ruling on such a parliamentarian point of order. We cannot let an unelected advisor determine which promises we fulfill and which we do not, especially when the vast majority of Americans in both parties want us to provide a pathway to citizenship. The moment is now. We urge you to reinstate a pathway to citizenship for Dreamers, TPS holders, farm workers, and essential workers in the Senate's version of the reconciliation bill. Thank you for your attention to this letter and your commitment to honoring the tributes that millions of undocumented individuals have paid to this country." And last night, the Senate Democrats had a meeting with the Senate parliamentarian over immigration where they hoped to reach some type of consensus. Previously, the parliamentarian ruled against the Democrats' attempt at placing immigration reform in the Build Back Better bill due to violations of the Byrd Rule, so it's likely that this one will be rejected as well. Okay, so once our lawmakers make their way back to Washington next week, they'll have just 5 days to prevent a government shutdown. That's right, on December 3rd, federal agencies will once again be running out of money. And at this point, no real progress has been made towards preventing it. Although the two leaders in the Senate, Chuck Schumer and Mitch McConnell, have had some talks, they haven't really reached any type of an agreement. As of right now, Chuck Schumer and the Democrats would like for Republicans to help them extend government funding and raise the debt ceiling in a bipartisan vote. However, as we all know, McConnell and Republicans wish for Democrats to do it in a more partisan manner through a reconciliation package. Due to political pressure, Republicans don't want to be the ones seen responsible for raising the debt ceiling, so they can use that to their political advantage. Democrats, on the other hand, say Republicans are being hypocrites for being against it now, when they contributed towards the debt over the past few years. Regardless, by December 3rd, they will need to figure out how to extend government funding, whether that be through another short-term deal, or perhaps something even longer. Additionally, the Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen claims that by December 15th, the debt ceiling will need to be raised once again. Again, there's no agreement in place to do so. Then, of course, this one being a soft deadline by Christmas or the end of this year, Democrats would like to have the Build Back Better bill signed into law. Once they return to Washington next week, they'll have just around 4.5 weeks to do so, giving them little time to get it done. That's going to be one of the biggest priorities for the Senate next week, with Joe Manchin and Kyrsten Sinema battling out with progressives such as Bernie Sanders for which measures get to stay in the bill. The Senate Majority Leader, Chuck Schumer, will need to carefully navigate the bill to ensure that the two sides of his party stay on the same page, and in order for the bill to pass in the Senate, they'll need at least 50 votes, with Vice President Kamala Harris obviously being the tiebreaker. So Democrats obviously can't afford to lose any votes here. Now, more than likely, whatever bill the Senate eventually passes is going to differ quite a bit from the House-passed bill. This means whichever bill they pass will need to be passed once again in the House. Once the House receives the Senate passed bill, at that point, they will also have an opportunity to make any necessary amendments, and if they change the bill once again, it'll go right back to the Senate. So let's say that Joe Manchin and Kyrsten Sinema successfully remove a lot of the measures that House progressives wanted in the bill, they may end up amending the bill to include them once again before sending it right back to the Senate. So as you can see, getting this bill signed into law by the end of this year is definitely going to be an uphill battle. Okay, so some other needs I really don't think are being talked about nearly enough is help for Social Security recipients. Even though recipients of Social Security will be receiving a 5.9% increase from the cost of living adjustment, those won't take place until next year, and we still have another month to go. So is the increase going to help? Definitely. But could some people and families use help even sooner? Definitely. Also. This is why some lawmakers are calling for Social Security reform, something that hasn't been done for many years. In one proposed bill, the Social Security 2100 Act, first off, it recognizes the fact that the trust fund may be running out of money in just 13 years. Because of that, the bill proposes extending that date to 2038 to give Congress a bit more time for a long-term solution. Secondly, in the bill, a higher minimum benefit for low-income workers would be seen, and they would be set at 125% above the poverty line and tied to current wage levels. Also, any cost of living adjustments made on a year-to-year basis would be tied to the Consumer Price Index for the elderly, with the argument being that these better reflect the cost seniors face. For example, the CPIE factors in around 11% of its index to healthcare cost, whereas the CPIW only counts healthcare for around 5.6%. And since seniors spend a lot more of their money on healthcare using the CPIE, theoretically, would mean larger adjustments. Of course, in order to get this bill passed, it would need to be bipartisan, which means needing every single Democrat on board with the bill, in addition to needing at least 10 Republicans. And even though both sides want some type of reform for Social Security benefits, Democrats and Republicans, unfortunately, have different ideas to fix the problem. Another bill that was proposed, called the Trust Act, was also introduced. This one, unlike the other one, is much more bipartisan. Of course, as I say, the Trust Act would not make any changes to these programs. Rather, it would set up a process to encourage bipartisan agreement to avoid automatic cuts that will happen if lawmakers do not act. Again, these cuts may begin happening as soon as 2034. Basically, each rescue committee would consist of 12 members of Congress appointed by the four corners of congressional leadership. Each commission would then be divided evenly between political parties, and they would be given the task of writing legislation to prevent fund depletion. So this wouldn't necessarily fix the Social Security shortfall, but rather, it would encourage a bipartisan effort to keep the programs going stronger in future years. Both of these bills haven't had much attention in recent weeks, mostly due to the infrastructure bill, and now the Build Back Better Act sort of taking center stage, but once they get out of the way, it seems like they should begin focusing a lot more on these other problems. But on that note, I'm going to go ahead and wrap up this video. Again, if you would like to receive a couple of free stocks from Webull, make sure to quickly claim them by clicking my link, which you will find in the description box below. To receive the first free stock, you will need to fully open an account. Then, to receive the second free stock, which will be valued up to $2,000, you'll need to make a qualifying deposit of at least $5. And even if you aren't all that interested in investing or continuing to invest at this point in time, you can always sell the free stocks you receive and transfer that money, however much they're worth, right back to your bank account. So free stocks or free money is completely up to you. So once again, I hope everyone has a great and safe rest of your day. I hope you have a very happy Thanksgiving tomorrow if I don't see you until Friday. And until next time, as always, I'll see you in the next video.